heel erg verheugd vanavond. Odyssey hier live in de studio. Amir is even aangeschoven. Amir, how you doing?
I'm good. How about yourself?
Coming from Berlin today, right?
Yeah.
How was the trip?
Long. Yeah, good sleep though. I needed it.
You've been at the North Sea Jazz Festival last weekend here in the Netherlands.
I was. North Sea was amazing. It was our first time there. Wonderful experience, you know. It's always interesting touring with a band. We find ourselves oftentimes being placed on the bills of festivals where we might only be the only hip-hop acts, you know, or one of a very few. And we consider that an honor, but it's also a challenge as well.
And how did the challenge work out?
I think the challenge worked out great. I think that the crowd really appreciated us and enjoyed our music as much as we enjoyed the festival.
You've been a busy man this year already, because this is your second release. Just a few weeks ago, you released the Odd Tape, completely instrumental. No tracks on that tonight here, because, of course, instrumental.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can imagine that. But I wanted to know, the Odd Tape is your day from start to finish, right?
Yeah, it's meant to be. It's meant to be like a musical soundtrack, like theme music. I think we all have theme music in our heads during the course of our days. Or maybe I'm just the only one who's crazy. I decided to pull that theme music out of my brain and actually put it on record.
But did you test the music on the particular moments of the day? Because there's going out music, there's waking up music, there's lunch music.
You know, I'm such a... Music is so attached to mood for me that in the process of making the instrumentals, I could immediately tell what they felt like. You know, I got so many playlists in my phone for breakfast playlists, cleaning the house playlists, laundry playlists, cooking dinner playlists, etc.
You should work at a streaming service. They have the most amazing playlists.
I'm sure. So it just fit. Those songs fit into the mood that I'm normally, the type of music I listen to during the course of a day.
But did you test them?
I didn't. I'm like a bad cook who doesn't test his food when he's cooking.
Oh my God. Oh, okay. And of course, this release just came a few months after the other one. It's an EP called Alwasta.
Alwasta.
What does that mean?
Alwasta. Best translation is the connected one, the plug. A person who has social currency, and that social currency is equal or more than wealth itself. It's a form of wealth.
A form of wealth.
Yeah.
It's a lyrics-wise pretty heavy EP, I thought, because the next song you're going to play is Lifting Words.
Shadows.
Lifting Shadows. Oh, I'm sorry.
No worries.
And it's got the lyric, "I got a name that'll scare all the brave in the land of the free, all in the name of protecting a country that's shooting its citizens dead in the streets." That's pretty much all the news of last weekend, last month, last year. Mm. And I wondered, you know, we're getting into the Republic Convention right now, tonight. What are your thoughts on that? Who should be, you know, the next president? Who can help us all a little bit? Yeah, it's a big question, but you're having big themes, so I thought, yeah, give me a little bit of your vision.
If we're talking exclusively about the American presidency, it's the lesser of two evils at this point, personally. I saw something online where it put it down to two votes, where it said, I'm Sudanese American. I'm Muslim. My mother's Black American. My father is Northern Sudanese. I'm Muslim, I'm Black, I'm Arab, I'm everything that's hated by everyone in the world. I saw something online that said, the vote is basically between blowing up my cousins or never letting my cousins come visit. That's the choice I have right now. You know, that's where I'm at. It's the lesser of two evils. I suppose I want them to stay alive. Maybe they can come visit later.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
But, yeah, I'm searching, and a lot of my peers are for, you know, little solutions, little things that we can do, you know, to make things better. And you, of course, in your music are doing this as well. You name the shit that's going down. But yeah, I think it's something we have to talk about like forever. Right?
Well, it's something we will always be a topic of discussion in society in general. It's cyclical. We've seen these periods of extreme thought and a move towards being more conservative, and then society becomes conservative and suppressed, and then it burst from underneath to that oppression and suppression to become liberal. We've seen that from Rome and its collapse, and then the medieval ages, and then the birth of the Renaissance, and then history has constantly seen this back and forth between extremes of freedom and oppression. It's nothing new. It's nothing new. We've been doing this since the beginning of civilization.
I know, but that's not, we want to do something? Yeah, yeah.
Well, we can, what are we going to do?
Nothing. Just mention it, I guess.
Sure, we can mention it, but I don't know. I think if you look back long enough in the history books, it almost feels a part of human nature. It almost, light gives birth to dark and dark gives birth to light. It almost seems that the minute we become more and more liberal, it makes people who are less liberal scared. And then those people react. And then people react to those people who are scared. And then they react. And then it constantly goes back and forth. It's probably partially the main reason we have a dual party system in the United States. One is liberal, one isn't, or one is supposed to appear to be liberal. Why is there a dual system? Why is a dual system working in a majority of democratic countries in the first place? Because it seems to be that we've narrowed human thought down to two perspectives.
Are you even going to vote?
I'm going to vote, definitely.
Yeah?
Definitely.
Everybody should vote?
Everybody who can vote should vote, for sure. As a Black American in the United States, not much has changed for us, regardless of who's in office. So it's amazing and impressive that we continue to support a system that constantly ignores our existence and lets us down. I'm from one of the wealthiest Black populations in the United States, where we've got some of the worst public schools in the United States of America, in the state of Maryland where I'm from. How is that possible? My mother, my grandmother have existed through the assassinations of some of our greatest leaders. What's changed for them? The roads on my neighborhoods are still unpaved. Taxes are still ridiculous. The public school systems are still a failure. Why is that? Which president has changed any of that for us? Okay, maybe there are things that I don't have a political mind to see that they've kept us safe from.
Mm-hmm.
Could be threats from abroad, quote unquote. But in my day-to-day life, in the day-to-day life of my band, what's changing, regardless of who's in office? Nothing. Nothing.
Is there any hope in this?
I'm not really sure. I'm not really in it for hope. You know, I'm born in a capitalist country, and I was raised in America with the perspective of an immigrant. I get in, I work hard, I take care of my surroundings, and that is the best thing that I've learned is, instead of spreading a broad message, spread a message to the people who you are in earshot of, and then hope that they do the exact same thing to the person next to them. And eventually that thought process and that ideology spreads more organically, and you tend to see more of an effect that way, where the way I think about life, if I can share it with my peers and then they can encourage their family members to do the same thing, I may not ever speak to their family personally, but the idea has been planted. I feel like that's the most effective way of making change, is a more organic, more home-based method versus a broad speech to everyone in the world at the same time.
We have a whole radio station for your voice right now. If you would like to go next door, spread the message all through the Netherlands.
Yeah, why not?
If you would like to
go
to
the... Let's do it.
Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, sure.